Hey, hi, how you doing? It's Jim. It's the evening of a day during the week. I don't know when it is. I've lost track. I spoke a week or two ago. Well, I didn't speak about it. I stuck a comment on the community tab of the YouTube channel about Mahavishnu Orchestra. And I was very kindly reminded a little while earlier that I'd teased about it, but I hadn't actually gone off as far as doing anything about it. Well, perhaps I should. So, this is a different album. This is Birds of Fire, which I bought off eBay. Now, the cover itself is a little bit tatty. It's obviously the original. And as you can see from the inner sleeve bit, the record is sort of kind of falling through it, so that's kind of all falling apart. But that doesn't really matter, because actually the record itself looks absolutely flawless. It looks like it's never been played. Now, it's probably going to be really horrible to stick it on. It's going to be crackling like crazy, but from a first look at it, it looks absolutely flawless. There's a tiny few little bits of dust here and there I can see, but I've certainly seen really, really poor looking records, and this isn't one. So, with a bit of luck, this will be okay. Right, so let's stick this on the turntable and whiz through and see what it's like. If you can see that, should be okay. Right. Oh, better get this recording, so it'll all be for naught otherwise. There we go. I'm quite excited about this, because what I did hear of the other album, I can't actually remember the name of the other one now, it kind of just, wow, blew me away. And so that I can listen to this absolutely, genuinely, for the very, very first time now, it's quite exciting. Really quite exciting, because a lot of people love this. I'm probably going to be one of those people soon. Here we go. Mahavishnu Orchestra, Birds of Fire. Actually, what are the tracks? What's this first track called? The first track is Birds of Fire. There we go. Right, 3, 2, 1. Bosh. Well, there's a little bit of cracklage, but nothing too bad. We'll be right back. hadn't realised. On the back cover here. Jan Hammer. John McLaughlin as a guitar. But down here, we got Billy Cobham drumming. Who knew? Drumming is incredible. Favorite, a fade out. Wow, that was a bit sort of This is a Miles Davis track now, Miles Beyond. Crispy. Intense, that's the word I was trying to think of on that first track. Violin, being plucked. Okay, we move on to celestial terrestrial commuters.